The man accused of strapping a fake collar bomb to schoolgirl Madeleine Pulver will soon be on his way back to Australia.
10's Daniel Sutton was at the court hearing in Louisville, Kentucky. Dan?
Well, this is the place Paul Peters has called home for the past month. The Oldham County Jail is not a place he's enjoyed staying. And so today he gave authorities the green light to send him back to Australia without a formal extradition hearing, although he won't be going anywhere until at least next week. He'll leave behind the black and white jail stripes and ankle shackles, but Paul Peters will be far from a free man, voluntarily returning to Australia to face allegations he chained a fake bomb to the throat of Sydney schoolgirl Madeleine Pulver.
He wants to get things moving because otherwise he's languishing in the jail here.
In court today, Peters signed an affidavit formally waiving the right to an extradition hearing.
How do you feel?
It's a good thing, I think.
New South Wales police will collect him as soon as Sunday. On home soil, he'll be charged over the attack, which left Sydney holding its breath.
We're happy that it'll be over sooner rather than later.
Peters was unhappy with conditions inside his US jail. Minimal exercise, cramped cells.
There's no natural light out there. It's all artificial light. And so it's not a very pleasant environment.
His ex-wife waved and smiled at Peters in court.
I'm fiercely loyal to Paul, so you're not going to get any comment from me.
She's now juggling three daughters with a planned dash down under.
But this case is still surrounded in mystery. It remains unclear exactly what link, if any, Mr. Peters has to the Pulver family. Sources here say police themselves are still filling in the blanks.
His US lawyer says an Australian legal team has already been hired.
Do you think that he will form some defence to this?
I'm sure he'll come up with something.
In Kentucky, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.